Honorable Vice Chairman, sir, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to speak on the Banking Regulation Amendment Bill 2017. The bill proposes to give more powers to the Reserve Bank of India to deal with the large accumulated non-performing assets. It works up to rupees 9.64 lakh crores as of December 2016. Another 2 lakh crores have been added during the first quarter of 2017. According to RBI, the corporate sectors alone accounts for 88% of the NPA. The RBI data shows that 40 to 50 defaulters alone account for 70% of the case contributing to the stressed assets. The banks may have to take a haircut of 60% worth rupees 2.4 lakh crore to settle 50 largest stressed assets with debt of 4 lakh crore. Indian banks need to provide at least 18,000 crore additionally towards the 12 accounts identified by the RBI for the reference of National Company Law Tribunal under the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code in financial year 2018. The banks have written off a total of 2.4 lakh crore worth of loans in the last 5 years, and this might have benefited for a few people, but the waiving of agriculture loans surely benefits millions of poor farmers and prevents suicides by them. Therefore, the center should bear the entire burden of farmers' loan waiver instead of putting the burden on the state governments. Sir, here I want to mention one thing, that the farm loans accounts is only 1% of the bad debts. However, there is a tendency to blame the loan waivers in the farm sectors. Being an agricultural economy, we cannot blame farm loan waivers alone for the erosion of harnessed credit culture. In several cases, factors operating at the global level determine the local trade trends. Taking the steel sector, for example, it accounts for 25% of the corporate bad debts. But starting from 2010 till December 2016, the Government of India allowed the free inflow of foreign steel products from Korea, Japan and China, etc., which offered low prices. The local manufacturers who availed huge loans, besides large investment, could not compete with them. The Government of India also did not come forward to the rescue through the effective exchange policy at that time. Consequently, they suffered heavy losses and ultimately they were pushed into the debt trap. This was the major reason for the huge default by this sector. More important is the laxity in the credit risk appraisal and loan monitoring by the banks. For example, in the case of MSME sectors, stringent collateral security is demanded. But I don't know whether such credit risk appraisal norms are enforced for the corporate sectors as in the case of MSME sectors. Even in the field of loan recovery, it is astonishing that so much concession and tolerance is given to the big players, while MSME and small and marginal farmers were harassed. Sir, in retrospect, the troubled accounts fall into three categories. One is genuine and circumstantial defaulters. Number two, willful defaulters. Number three, habitual offenders. The genuine and circumstantial borrowers are unable to repay loans due to the downturn of the industry, largely conditioned by global economic trends. Such people can be given time to perform, provided the projects are viable and business models are robust and the chances of recovery are bright. But in the case of the willful defaulters, the institutional interventions like joint lenders forum, corporate debt restructuring, strategic debt restructuring, and scheme for sustainable structuring of stressed assets are already in operation. The performance of the asset reconstruction companies, which are mostly in private sector and which deal with the NPAs, are not satisfactory. While appreciating the current set of well-calibrated policy initiatives for resolution of the stressed assets, the onus is now shifting to RBI in the recovery process. On one hand, the borrowers will have to modify their priorities towards regular repayment of loans if they want to stay in the business. On the other hand, the bill offers great relief for and freedom for bank management also. 1-2 minutes, sir. Honorable Chairman, sir, the Vice Chairman, sir, in conclusion, the amended package empowers the RBI in regulating the process of resolving the stressed assets as well as the way of dealing with the defaulters. The bad loan scenario in this country is certainly grim. Therefore, the resolve of the government is taking the problem through the bill is a big boost to the Indian economy in general and the banking sector in particular. Without a strong and healthy banking system, it is difficult for the developing country like India to become economically superpower. But at the same time, without a time-bound, effective and foolproof recovery system, it is doomsday for the sustainability of the banking sector. Now, with the passage of this bill, it becomes the responsibility of the Reserve Bank of India, the public and private sector bank, and the high-profile borrowers to work in tandem and make it successful. With this, I conclude and support this bill. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Sri.